There is no election that there is no rigging. You can quote me on that. But you don't rig where you are not popular. It's more of a futuristic thing than a realistic thing. Now, if you say you are going to do election in my place electronically, it means you are deliberately going to disenfranchise my people. As a representative of the people from Borno and specifically Southern Borno, we are not ready. We don't have the facilities. As I'm speaking to you now, I cannot pick my phone and call somebody in my town. The credibility of an election does not depend on the method of transmission. And in fact, the electronic system is more susceptible to manipulation than the manual one. Manually is the best. Who are the Nigerians talking about this restructuring, if you see? These are people that just pick up themselves the leadership without mandate. Kanu will come out and be insulting everybody in the name of Biafra. It's very unfair and it's very irresponsible. It's not just somebody that will come up and say he's an IPOP leader and that he's leading Biafran this thing, insulting people anyhow and doing it childishly and then threatening people and all that. We did not get this country through threat or even fight. If there is no corruption and there is no failure of law and order and there is no injustice and inequality, people will not be talking about all this. Who is responsible for this injustice and inequality? Everybody is involved, especially the elites. I feel for those people, our youths, especially those from the north, and even those from the south, that their parents suffer to educate them, thinking that they will bring better life to their family, only to find out that they can't even get a job. They are so qualified, but they can't get a job. We have Yoruba Nation, we have Igbo Nation. Who is telling you all this? There is no Igbo again, only Nigeria. There is no Yoruba, only Nigeria. If you go to north, even the remotest part, you will find a Hausa man married to a Yoruba man. Some people just sit down in one village in Yoruba and they have not seen the horizon of Nigeria and they just sit down there and call themselves local champion. Let them go and be local government chairman. They can't because they are not electable. And then the Igbos, he come and allow one, Kanu, to say he's a Yoruba leader. A Mazi, they call him Wazi. Mazi, what kind of Mazi? And their leaders who are elected come together to say, this is how to resolve it. I mean, when people are engaged in criminalities and trivialities, you should just deal with them according to the law. All the parties in Nigeria are built on just platforms, not truly parties. If you can't beat them, join them. It doesn't matter. It doesn't touch on the concept. I know you are talking about recent defection of governors, even my friend Fani Kayode, despite the fact that people are criticizing him for. No. When you see a better alternative, why not? And I think he's right to have done that. When PDP left, they left us in a very bad shape. And now we are better off. I think it's high time now for all the PDP governors in the south to decamp to APC, the National Assembly, or the 9th National Assembly particularly, has been doing everything or whatever the executive does. And it has, created some suspicion and even leading to what you are trying to call me now. Look at me, older than you, and you say, I am rubber stamp. I am against any borrowing that you will do in order to pay salaries or overhead costs. If need be, you can shut down the National Assembly or make it part-time or pay as you earn, or you call it, or daily pay. You can turn those into daily pay. If you come and sit, you pay your allowance and salary for that day. How come your overhead is going up when people are not working? How come you are paying people and they are working from home? How come you are paying legislators and they are not sitting? How come is the overhead cost of running a government increasing and the number of employees is not increasing? People are working from home. And all those movements like fueling, vehicles and all, nobody is moving. Everybody at one time was shut down. Yet that cost is going up. Nobody is asking questions. These are the things that Nigerians are supposed to be asking. I said it again, that the presidential system is very expensive. and it's not good for us. We should really look at the possibility of converting this constitution, moving from the American presidential system, which is too expensive, to a parliamentary system.